Surprise Comics.
I am so incredibly excited to announce the next Bryze Comics exclusive from none other than Tyler freaking Kirkham. Boom! Holy smokes, you guys. I am in utter disbelief that I get to work with artists and creators like Tyler Kirkham to produce unique comic book covers for my comic book shop. I am in absolute disbelief that this is actually happening, but it is happening, and Tyler Kirkham absolutely nailed this cover. This is for Noctera, the Blacktop Bill special. It's a one-shot that releases on December 22nd. And I just want to look at it here with you guys. I just cannot believe how freaking awesome this image is from Tyler Kirkham. It's got Blacktop Bill right there in the center. He's a shadow character, which is not easy to get right, but Tyler nailed it. One of my favorite things about the entire image is how Blacktop's blade is shimmering there in the light, and the rain is bouncing off the blade, and that's where Tyler signed it. The line for the top of the T goes the whole length of the sword, adding contour to the sword and crossing the T. It's just such an awesome little detail, and it's my favorite part about the whole thing. And if this looks familiar to you, it's because it is. This is a cover homage to the original Matrix movie poster. And the thing about it is that it's totally uniquely its own thing. It doesn't have to be an homage at all, but it is, and it's just kind of a little bonus. You're like, oh yeah, now I do recognize that is from the Matrix. But the art is so good on its own. It's a completely standalone thing. I just thought it would be fun to do a Matrix homage because I'm a big fan of Keanu Reeves and I'm a big fan of the Matrix, and we have the Matrix 4 coming out, which just by chance is released the exact same day as this comic on Wednesday, December 22nd. The comic book releases and Matrix 4 releases. They're totally unrelated except for my little homage. But what a great way to celebrate the release of the Matrix 4 than with a comic book movie poster homage. So pre-sales for this exclusive go live Tuesday, December 14th at BryzeComics.com. There's going to be a limited number of CGC 9.8 Signature Series signed by Tyler Kirkham. Last time I did an exclusive, the Signature Series went super quick. So if you want to secure one of those, make sure you set an alarm on your phone or something like that. 12 o'clock noon Pacific time, Tuesday, December 14th. There's also going to be two opportunities to win a CGC 9.8 Signature Series on Tyler's Instagram page and on my Instagram page. So there'll be a chance to win one, but if you don't want to risk it, you can secure yours starting Tuesday at noon. This exclusive is going to be limited to 400 copies. So the way I did it is I ordered 600 copies, but I'm going to tear the covers off of 200 copies. Those will be available free on the website just as reader copies, but it'll be removed from the print run so that the comic book is more limited. It's limited to 400, and it accounts for, I don't have to worry about shortages and damages. I have 200 books that I'll just pick the ones that have any little ding or anything, tear the cover off, and offer that for free. I'll tape the cover back on so you have the whole thing. The easiest way that I found to get around damages and shortages is just to overorder and offer those damaged copies for free. That way I don't have to wait for replacements. I don't have to worry about if they're going to replace, and I don't have to worry about shortages. It gives me a really nice buffer. And yes, it is an added cost on my end, but for me, it's worth the headache to get nice copies out to people and not have to wait for replacements. All right, so a little bit about the series, about the Noctera series in general. The concept is you have to stay in the light or hitch a ride with Valentina, the ferryman who escorts people and goods along unlit roads with her luminescent 18-wheeler. And I'm going to put on the screen here some interior panels from the trade paperback of the first five issues of Noctera, which you can actually go pick up the trade paperback now, familiarize yourself with the series. But the one-shot special, my exclusive, is also its own jumping-off point. But as you can see from the interior panels, the The imagery in this series is so freaking awesome with the lights and the luminescent 18-wheeler. I cannot wait to see this translated onto the screen, which brings me to the point that, as most people know, Scott Snyder already confirmed that a TV deal has been reached for this series with Netflix. It's happening. It's coming to Netflix. And in addition, writer Robert Pattino is attached to produce it for Netflix. So it's well on its way. People are attached. It's coming. And I cannot wait to see this on the screen because of the imagery. Like, I just can't wait to see that, the lights, and also Blacktop Bill. Blacktop Bill is a shadow character, and he's the big bad for Noctera. So I want to see how they do a shadow character on the TV screen. I'm not sure that I've ever seen that before on a show or movie, but I'm bad at remembering stuff like that. So about my exclusive and this special, Noctera Blacktop Bill special is a one-shot, and it's the origin of Blacktop Bill. So we're going to get him on a Netflix show. There's a little bit of spec behind this because it's the origin of the big bad. Couple that with just this incredible, awesome artwork from Tyler Kirkham. It's a limited series. I mean, what an awesome, awesome collectible to have. Big shout out to Tyler Kirkham. Thank you so much for working with me on this. Thank you so much for nailing it and for all of the awesome content and imagery and artwork that you provide for the community. You're one of the main reasons I got back into comics. Some of your exclusive covers with Venom got me back into Venom. It's just incredible to be able to work with you. Thank you so much for everything that you do. And thank you to you guys watching, the subscribers, for the support. Thank you for considering picking this up. Right now, it's the absolute best way you can help support this channel is to buy an awesome collectible. It's a win-win. You support the channel and you get the just this epic, epic collectible. And with that, enjoy today's show, which is top 6 keys under $50 to buy now. Peace. First on the list, we have Infinite Crisis number 5. This is the first cover appearance and the first full appearance of Jaime Reyes, the third Blue Beetle. And this is a movie that is coming to HBO Max. No set release date yet, but we did get the first glimpse at DC Fandom for the concept art for the costume, which looks pretty darn epic. So this being a modern book, stick with 9.8 candidates. Ask for lots of pictures if you're buying on eBay, but you can find 9.8 candidates all day for under $50. The George Perez variant is even more affordable at about $25. So if anything, a good ROI for buying raw and getting graded. Number 2 on the list, we have Devil Dinosaur number 1, the first appearance of Devil Dinosaur and Moon Boy. And as most know, an animated series for Disney Plus is confirmed for 2022 called Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur. And considering that you can't find a near mint copy of Moon Girl's first appearance for under $50, which is a modern book, this seems like a great value. We still haven't got all the promotions for this series, so there is likely at least one more bump in prices coming. However, if the show is received well, or if it becomes clear that Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur have a greater role in the MCU, there could be more potential spikes for the values of this book. Either way, nothing but upside for this book if you get it now. There are plenty of copies raw for around the $50 in the near mint range, and CGC 9/8 are going for about $500. Number 3 on the list, we have Star Wars number 71. First full appearance of Bossk, a bounty hunter that is rumored to appear in the Book of Boba Fett coming soon to Disney Plus. And his first cameo appearance was in Marvel Comics Super Special number 16. Fantastic key. Check out the video I did on Swaggle Hoss's channel for details on that great book. But this book can be found in the near mint range for under $50, and CGC 9.8s are in the $300 to $400 range. Next up, we have a great buy the dip opportunity in X-Men 4, first appearance of Omega Red. Now, if you're rolling your eyes or just sick of hearing about Omega Red and X-Men number 4 because he's been rumored so many times for shows or movies and yet nothing has come from it, that is precisely why this book is on the list and the very definition of buy the dip. This is the perfect time to buy a key comic like this when you are just so sick of hearing of it because the hype is completely gone. That's the time to buy, because one actual confirmation about this character character coming or showing up in the MCU, like official confirmation, and you can bet that this book will be a repeat offender on the hot and trending list. And we've seen just from speculation alone how high this book can go, and I would expect to see even new heights for this book. Near mint raw copies are under $50, closer to the $25 range in most cases these days, and you can even get a near mint raw newsstand copy for around $50 right now, and high grade newsstands definitely demand a premium for this book, especially with a book that has so many copies. People are going to want the newsstand even more because it just differentiates it from all of the rest of the crowd. And number five, we have Black Hammer number one. This is the first appearance of Black Hammer and at least eight other characters that are important to the storyline. There's a director's cut, which is a sketch version, a Jeff Lemire cover B, and a Fabio Moon variant, which is a Justice League number one homage, and of course the cover A, but all of which right now can be had for around $50 or less. The cover A is sometimes a little bit more expensive for that, but they do come up for auction often, and they almost always end for under $50. So set an alert on eBay and be on the lookout for cover A at auction. This series was optioned back in 2018, and in 2019, Jeff Lemire went on record to say that it was well underway, but we haven't heard much about the show since. And the comic book universe of the Black Hammer, however, does continue to expand with new titles released this year like Black Hammer Reborn, and COVID is likely the culprit of the reason why we haven't heard updates on the show. It took a huge toll on Hollywood, shut things down for a long time, and that likely could be the holdup in this series, which means it could be a perfect opportunity to buy while there is very little attention on this book and likely some upcoming announcements coming very soon. Number six on the list is X-Men 205. This is the first cameo appearance of Hope Summers, the adopted daughter of Cable, and she only appears in this issue as a baby on the last panel, but collectors and even CGC consider this her first appearance because it's not like there's a second solid choice for her first full appearance because she appears as a baby for some time, so it's an interesting situation where the cameo is actually going to be the money book. Either way, I think this will continue to be the money book for Hope Summers. She plays an important role in comics and could easily be worked into a bigger role in the MCU. If nothing else, this is a great book to buy raw and get graded because raw near mint copies are available for under $50 and CGC 9.8s are in the $300 range. There's also a J. Scott Campbell variant that's a little more pricey because the cover art is absolutely stunning. And a second print, which is one of the best interior panels from the actual comic used as the cover, and that one is actually a little bit more affordable than cover A, and all three of those covers are great picks for this key. Thank you so much for sticking with me all the way to the end, and we'll catch you in the next video. Bye.
Bryze Comics.